Good day. Today, in our class, you are going to talk on how to use yourself. And the class is going to go for a very orientation, which is going to go for free. And then, my name is Toyo Baxter Abiodun. I'm a data analyst, a statistician. So, we are going to talk on how to use Excel for beginners. And if you like and enjoy this class, please subscribe for our class, and the link is in the description. Now we are going to start the class with the content. Now we are going to move to our slide, the content below. Excel is organized to allow calculations layout in tabular form. More as we would lay out the same calculations if we were doing them with paper and pencil. And now let's move to our course contents. In our course contents, firstly, we will be looking at the introduction to Microsoft Excel software interface. Then, we go to the functionalities of Microsoft Excel. Then, shortcuts of Microsoft Excel. And the bonus package in this screen, Excel for beginner easy data entry strategies. Now, let's begin with our first contents, which is introduction to Microsoft Excel software interface. On the Microsoft Excel software interface, we have the title bar, which shows the active document names and can minimize, maximize, or close the application window. We also have the menu bar. The menu bar contains with the command that can be utilized in Excel. It can also minimize, maximize, or close the current file in the documents windows. We have the toolbars. The toolbars contain buttons that quickly access most utilized menu commands. Then the worksheets. The worksheet or spreadsheet is used to store and manipulate data. Status bar. The status bar indicates the current status of the document. The active cell. Active cell has a bold black border around it. It indicates the current cell that is selected and that information can be typed into that cell. The reference area makes a reference to active cell A1 and identify a selected object. Then we have the formula bar. Display the current data that is being entered or edited in the active cell. Now, before we move on, let me show how the Excel component and where it is on the Excel worksheet itself. Now, we will be going to our Excel worksheet. This is our Excel worksheet. Here, this is our worksheet. In this worksheet, we have the title bar, menu bar, toolbar, status bar, the reference area, and so on. Now, here, our title bar, as I already said, we can minimize, maximize, or close the application window using our title bar. Now here, this is our title bar. You can see minimize, maximize, close, and we have our title bar here. Now we have the menu bar, which contains the menu with command that can be utilized in Excel. It can also minimize and maximize as well. We have the toolbar. As well on the worksheets, and we have the worksheet itself, which is the spreadsheet that I'm viewing. We have the status bar, the active cell, like which has the both black, both green around the active cell. So looking at the both green border around it, it indicates the current cell that is selected, and that information can be typed into that cell. Now you can type any information to this cell, like 1, 2, 3. Let's clear that one. You can also type A, B, C, and so on. Just that's our active cell. Now we can make reference to that active cell. The active cell is GNI, but by making reference, we go to our status bar, because this is our status bar here, and we change the name of the cell. By giving it something else, because I've used SD before, that's why you can see SD there. I'll just leave a reference to that cell, which means it's no more G9. Now the formula bar display the current data that is being entered or edited in the active cell. Now as I have 1, 2 in my active cell here, I have 1, 2, 3. You can see this is my formula bar here. You can see how the formula bar is displaying what I've entered into my active cell. Once I move away from that cell to another cell, the formula bar will be empty until I enter anything into that active cell, like let's say A, B, C. You can see that the ABC is displaying on the formula bar. Now, from here, we go back to our study. I'm still talking about the introduction to Microsoft Excel interface. Under the introduction to Microsoft Excel interface, we have the formatting cell as well. Now, on the formatting cell, what we'll be doing here is showing you how to enter text or numbers, select the cell where information is to be entered, then type in the characters using the keyboard and press enter. For column row and size, to resize column or row, drag the line in between the column or row, heading to the desired size, or double click on the line in the column or row heading. Same with the selecting cell. We have the alignment, we have the text font, size, the format you want. We have the numbers, we have the formulas, the sum numbers in a row, and so on and so forth. So we will go into our friend the Excel worksheet now to show how to do all the formatting. We are now on the formatting source. Now, to enter text and numbers on Excel, to enter text or number, you select the cell that you want to enter the information, then type in the character using the keyboard and press enter. Okay, let's say as I give an example I'm using before, I want to enter 1, 2, 3 general. From that, so you can see 1, 2, 3, now A, B, C, enter, and so on and so forth. You can enter number, you can enter text. Now the column and row size, as you can see here, you are seeing hash. The reason why you are seeing the hash there is because color number text that was entered into this column is not the same with the size of the cell there. Now to auto resize this, there are many ways to resize this column and row to fit the information in the each particular cell. To do this, there are many ways. You can just come here, highlight, and then double click on the line between each of the cell. You can see that all the rows and column has been fit to the information that we have in each cells. Now from there, so we can do this in another way using the auto resize and hold on, by going to the cell format, we have many kind of formats and all there. Now we'll be using the cell format to show you how to do the auto resizing of the colon and rows of the cells you are working on. Now they'll go to format, then on the dialog box, auto fit the row height. Oh, sorry, I've not selected what I want to resize. So from there to format, auto fit the row height, then format again, auto fit the column width. You can see that all has been said by doing the auto fitting for the rows and column. Now from there, we'll now be going to selecting cell or highlight. To select a cell or highlight cell, drag the mouse button from the beginning cell to the end cell. To select enter row or column, click on the rows or column setting. Now to select a cell, let's say I want to select from January to June. Here now, I'll be selecting from January to June. As you can see, that's what we call selecting or highlighting. So I click on where I want to start and I drag my mouse down to June. Now I can select the entire column. Let's say I want to select the entire the one by, you can see. So I forgot to tell you this. Rows are labeled by number and columns are labeled with letter A, B, C. As you can see, this is our row A, B, C, D, E. We have here as hence where it is where you want your information to stop. And our row, we have it in numbers 1, 2, 3 and so on and so forth to where it stops. Now from here, now to select the entire row here, just click on the headings of the row, which is 1, you can see, for column as well. And you can select as many as possible. Just click and drag your mouse down to where you want to sit, where you want to highlight your data. Seems good for the row. Now from there, we'll be going to the alignment. The default alignment for text is left, and the default alignment for a number is to right. To change a cell's alignment, select it and choose an alignment button on the toolbar. So as you are seeing it, this now I can align it to the left or right. Here now, as you can see, left, middle, anywhere. I can do anything on using my alignment like that. So from there, we'll be talking about the text font style, text font, the text style and the size. Now what we mean by the text font size? Now the text font is, as you can see here, this is the font tool. This is where all the font information is on Azure. As you can see here, we have our font here. This is the toolbar for fonts. This is our menu bar here, but this is the toolbar for fonts. Now to work on the font size here, yeah? And the font style and the font, the font size, the text font and everything. Now you can see our text font is in Calibri. You can change it to Times New Roman, Algerian, anything you want from using the right clicking and doing from the dialog box. You can see where the text font is, then the style as well. As you can see, if you want to change this to italic or any other thing, from, as you can see it here now is in normal, so you can change this to italic, you can underline it, you can bold it. So let's just remove that. Anything, as you can see, you see how double underline. So from there, you can change the test style as well, test size as well, from 11 to 10, from 11 to 12, and so on and so forth. You can change it to any size you want. That's what we mean by test font size. Now we have the numbers. To format numbers, choose the format menu and choose the numbers option then choose the appropriate number format from the dialog windows. Now, as in the number format, I mean the toolbars for number here, we can change the number. As you can see here, now we are having our data in accounting, all the information is there in accounting. So we want to change it to normal stuff, like moving from accounting to another. Let's say you just want to use numbers. You can see that we don't have any dollar signs, and it's from here now. As you can see, our row. You can leave that because of the heading. So let's set up on another one. So let's open that. Now, the formulas. Let's talk about formulas. Yes. Now, as you are seeing this worksheet, you can insert above this cell below. Let's say I want to insert another cell above this. I'll just click insert. You can see I've insert above. So now I want to show you how to use formula on Excel. To start a formula in Excel, the first thing you type on your keyboard is equal to. Then from that, and maybe you want to add, let's say you want to do the sums of the sales of first products from January to June, just highlight, then enter. Oh, sorry, you can't use that unless you are using some. You'll be doing this one by one by clicking from equal to now, then let's highlight it from the formula toolbar. Equal to is in our the active cell for it. Equal to for January maybe is B2, then from there plus on your keyboard to the second one, plus to the third one, plus to the fifth one, plus to the next one, plus and check the last one, which is June. Plus, then enter. No, you don't need plus anymore, just enter. Then you can see that we have the same thing. You can cross check whether you're having the right answer by looking down here. You can see the sum of the selected cells. Where I said the cell that I selected. Okay, from there, let's go back to our slide. Let me give the overview of what we've been doing since morning before going to what we've done on the formatting source before going to the formula examples, because there are many examples of formula. Now, before I talk on the formula examples, because we are going to go back to our Excel interface. Now, the overview of this is that any text entered in a spreadsheet can be formatted in a number of ways, including changing its font style, font size, making it bold, italics, and so on. Metadata can also be formatted in a variety of ways, as can be gathered from the totals, dollar, percentage, etc. on the right side of the total bar. And the area just above the row of the column label contains a field given the currently active cell. And here you have your test data and formula as shown, as they are typed in and where they can be later edited. This area is referred to as the formula bar, as I told you before, where I edited my formula the other time. Now, we'll now be going back to our Excel to show you the examples of formula. And Excel, how to use the formula. Although I've already shown you the examples of formula on Excel, the first thing is to type the equal to, then from there move to from there be selecting what you want to equal. So I think let's move to the next slide by showing you the types of formula on Excel for now, by not wasting your time. Now, yeah, I'm going back to the I will be going back to our Excel view, the Excel worksheet, sorry. I will be copying my data here to another sheet to show you how the types of formula we have on our Excel sheet. Now, to copy, we use Ctrl C or right click, then select copy from the dialog box that displayed. Okay, now let me go to the formula sheet. I think I will start to show how to use that letter, then delete this. We can paste here now. Now, I will be showing the types of formula on Excel. There are many types of formula on Excel. There are many built-in functions on Excel as we have in our programming language today. The types of formula on Excel. Using the previous example of the Excel built-in function. Using the previous example, one of the Excel built-in function in the function sum, which compose sum of value in a range of cells. There are several built-in formulas and it is a challenge to remember them all. You can use one of the smart icons or in your icon bar to help. To do this, now this one of the smart icons on our icon bar, you can use the formula bar. Now, let's say we want to do the total from January to June here for the sale of the first product, second product, and third product. How to do this? I'll be showing you this now. Now, just go to your formula here, where the all the built-in function on Excel. Click. Then, as you can see in the dialog box display, it's telling us to type a brief description of what we want to do, and then click go. What this means is that whether we want to add, we want to subtract, we want to do anything, you can see that I have a box I have the most recently used and so on. Now from here, let me say I want to add some. And by clicking go, you can see I have some here. If I click on OK, automatically Excel will in the figure above, as you can see in the next dialog, the second dialog box. As you can see in the second dialog box, as shown above, the purpose of this dialog box is to upset one argument for the function. In this example, the spreadsheet guesses that you wish to sum the cells, starting with the first one from the top with numerical data in it. That is, it will select the first one here that is in test, is in string format, sales of first product. So, Excel will guess that you want to start from here, from the one with the first numerical data. So, by clicking OK, we have our total here. As well, you want to calculate the average, you want to know the mean. Let's say you want to calculate the average, then again, we get here, when select saying you want to do the average, or you type mean, average, then go, you can see we have average, okay. Now here you need to edit, because Excel will request that you want to do the average of the total as well. So, what we are going to do here is that we are going to edit what is showing in this dialog box by doing it like this, B7. That's where our data stops. So, by clicking OK, we have it like that. So, from there, we will be dragging. Let's change the number format to number. Now, from here, just let's drag the formula for the sales of the second product and the third product as well. Doing that again for this. That's the formula types on Excel. Now, let's go back to our slide. Now we are back to our slide. Let's log the next activities on our slide. You can see these are our results of the formula, that the formula of what we have been doing since morning. Now we are now we'll be talking about the graphs and charts on Excel. A chart is a graphical representation of worksheet data. Charts can make complex data easy to understand, as I already said before. Starting a chart, all the last step, the first chart on Excel, we have a category labeled the data series and the chart format. So let's go to Excel and show you how to do the charts. Let's say we want to visualize the sales of the first product here from the month of January to June. We can do it for the three. Now, from here, from on our Excel, we go to Insert, then to the Chart toolbar. Now, there are many types of charts. We have the histogram, the bar, the line charts, the pivot charts, the line, and the area charts, and so on. The scatter, if you want to select the scatter, just guys click. Okay, let's work on pie chart here. Now we need to analyze what you want to visualize. This time you want to visualize here, then to your charts, then insert. As you can see, there are many types of chart size here, as we have for our number format. So it's very visualized and be looking the data ambiguous. So we can do that for the second sales as well, by highlighting the month, then the second product, it goes to insert again, chart, as you can see. We have again the sales of the second product. You can see we have many types. There are many types. As we make it look beautiful, select the one that will make it look beautiful. So, let's say we want to do for her. You can do that for the third product on your own. That is an assignment for you. Now, let's say we want to do for her. We will be using histogram like quick layout. You can see. Can see now there are many things on Excel. Now you can see the status bar is telling that chart 2. If I click on this now, it will be chart 1. I have 2 charts on this worksheet. Wow, this is very nice. Now I will be going, I want to visualize all the information I have here on one chart. That I will be using my histogram or bar charts. Insert. Let me use this. You can see you can use the recommended chart, which one, that one will be as default. We recommend the best chart for you. You can see we have the line charts here, we have the clustered column, we have many type of chart: line, star column, the star area, star column. Now we are selecting this, click on OK. That's my chart view. As you can see, there are many types of view. I can select this here. From here, this chart is telling me that in January, the sales of the first product is higher than the second product and the third product. And second product is higher than the third product. In February, sales of the first product is higher than the second product. Why is it of the same? Simply for her. So now let's go back to our slide and quickly talk on the data form. Because it's a bonus package, that's why you are not seeing the data form here. But since it's a bonus package, I will be showing you how to enter data on Excel in any form. Let's say you have a questionnaire. You want to code the questionnaire on Excel. There are many ways to do that. Yo, let me just show you how to do that on Excel. I'll be going now straight away to my Excel worksheet, our friend. That's our friend for now. Excel worksheet, the only two friends we have. To start a data form in Excel, firstly, you have to name the name of your variable. Let's say you have a questionnaire with name, name, age, height, weight, and so on. Now you want to do the data form for this. Now first thing is, so let me tell you, because data form is not automatically on the title bar of Excel, or let me say menu bar, it's not automatically, you will need to install it from the hard bins. The first thing is you are going to click on files, then to option. From the option, we will now go to the quick access toolbar. Then we look for change this from popular command to all command. Then look for where form is, because we want to work on form. There are many commands here. So I think I've seen my own form. I know you will be looking for your own as well. Because this form, click on it, then because I've already had it, you can see you already have this on your quick access toolbar. Okay, after that it should be have here, then click on OK. Then let's say we have this. I now want to do the data form. This is now, this is my form here, what I just added to my quick access toolbar. That's another toolbar on Excel, quick access toolbar. Then you click on OK. Then the name, let me use my name, last string. Yeah. You can see I have it there. But I still want to do something on that. I don't need to. You can see, just click on that one. And the out there, what my age? Let's say my age is 12 years. And then click on tab to go to the next. Then what's your height? Let's say the height is 6.7. Then I have the weight. Let's say the weight is 63.5 kg. Then I want to do another one. Just press enter or click on new. So you'll be entering the data. Let me enter another data name, that your age 14, height 5.6, weight 56.7 kg. That's how it will be going. Once we finish, just close it. We'll be having this whole entire data on it. So let's say you have a questionnaire with plenty, after coding it, just be answering it. It will make your work faster and easier and faster.